Hello everybody, Flamin' Shark back with another video, and today we're going to be jumping in to Amphibia, episodes 2 to 4, or 4 to, I guess it would be 3 to, what, 3 to 8? We're watching the next 3 episodes, well I mean really the next 6, but you guys know, fucking A and B, 11 minute, 22 minute garbage, you guys know what I'm talking about. We're watching some Amphibia. Season 1, episodes 2 to 4 is how this is going to be titled. Last time we were introduced to a new universe and a new cast of characters, most notably the main characters, Anne, and it seems like Sprig is probably going to be the other main character based on the intro and how the beginning episodes played out. We had a nice moment at the end where we got the tease of Sasha and Marcy, who are the other two Anne's best friends that also have ended up in this frog world, Amphibia, as I'm just going to refer to it as. I forget if there actually was a mention of what the world was called. But we also got Hopadiah, very funny name, and we have Polly. Those are our, I guess, like main kind of group, like Anne's group. You got Sprig, who's clearly going to be like the co-main character, and then you have Polly, who's the sister, and then, of course, Hopadiah, old daddy. But, yeah, curious to see where it goes. Obviously, Sasha and Marcy will have to do, I think, more, like, the more long-term stuff for the show, but we'll see where it goes. Like I said, I'm expecting, hopefully, some fun episodes, and I'm not really looking for much else. I'm looking for, colorful cast and characters that I can get invested in. That's really what I'm looking for out of the early episodes. I kind of, with any Western animated show, especially if it's like Disney or Cartoon Network or one of the main TV networks, I kind of, in the modern era and really in general, I tend to give these quite a bit of a pretty long leash, especially early on, to impress me, because a lot of the more iconic shows of the last 10 years from these networks have tended to be a bit patient, a bit slow to get into their more intense, deeper stories that they want to tell, and use the first whatever amount of episodes, in many cases the first season, to build the characters and to make you more worry about you getting invested with the characters than actually producing a strong narrative, necessarily like an overarching narrative with intrigue over the course of multiple episodes and stuff. I've talked about this before countless times. We've reacted to so many cartoons, so many Western shows over the last 10 years, because I've been doing this almost 10 years, fucking Christ. But we could talk about that. There's countless examples I could bring up. But we'll see. We'll see. They did kind of do a thing a little bit like the ending of the first episode of Gravity Falls at the end of episode 1B, where it was like, oh, here's the hook. So we'll see how it goes. I'm excited for this. Before we jump into episode 2A or episode 3, I'm going to call it 2A. Before we jump into episode 2A, I do have a little, it's about 50 seconds, but I have a, apparently OP is called Welcome to Amphibia by, Selisa Gray. I don't know if that's Selisa. Could be Celica. Celica or no, it's like Celica? Celica? I actually don't know. Celica Gray? I'm gonna assume it's Celica Gray, actually. By Celica Gray. Which, is apparently the opening theme with lyrics. I mean, I wasn't super impressed with the opening theme for Amphibia. It felt like the type of opening theme that was meant to support a lyrical song, and yet wasn't a lyrical song, and I thought that was really weird. And I feel like a lot of, I feel like we're seeing this too much, where these shows are using instrumentals as opposed to songs with lyrics for their OPs, which sometimes can work. Like, I think the Gravity Falls OP was tremendous, and I think it worked very well as a lyricless song. But that's more the exception than the rule, in my opinion. You know, there are some great lyricless songs. I mean, of course, one of the greatest anime OPs of all time, Cowboy Bebop, is another great example, of course. But more often than not, I want some lyrics, and I'm excited to see what these are, and I'm probably going to be upset that they didn't use this as the actual OP for the whole series. But let's find out. Welcome to Amphibia by, I'm going to assume it's Celica Gray. I honestly have no idea, but Celica sounds right. So let's jump into this OP in 3, 2, 1, and play. Mm-hmm. This is the same. Yep. Yep. Now I find myself in the wild unknown with the frogs and toads, and I'm far from. She definitely sounds like a country singer. Nice leap. Yep, yep, hop. When you're a normal girl living in another world, what you gonna do? You gotta ribbit, ribbit, jump on in it. Welcome to Amphibia life. Don't get much crazier. So sure. Yeah, I like that better than the normal OP for sure. I think a couple of those lines were maybe a little too much, but then again, this show is definitely giving off that kind of tone, so. Interesting, interesting, interesting. I mean, obviously that video was so short and it was just a song, so I pretty much couldn't say anything during it, but yeah, I mean, I like it. I think it's a good song. I mean, I think it's charming. I mean, honestly, that song was 50 seconds. Like, why couldn't you have a 50 second? Honestly, I wouldn't have mind like a 50, like just that whole sequence be the OP and just use the whole like 50 second song, because it's only 50 seconds. I know usually these TV cartoons have like a 20 second, maybe 30 second OP, but I mean, 50 second OP? Yeah, honestly, I would have used that whole thing, but you could even use an excerpt and like cut off after the first like ribbit, ribbit, and like whatever it was. I already forgot. But that was pretty cool. Not like incredible. I don't think that was like as iconic. But the thing is that if it was the OP, we'd hear it over and over again for every episode, and maybe it would grow on me. I did like it. Like I said, I think they should have ran with that. And it was very charming. I think the sound fit pretty well. Because like I said, it had a bit of a country vibe. I'm not a big country fan, but it wasn't, you know, overbearingly country. But honestly, country kind of fits with this show because it's a... Like, it's kind of almost like a country setting. I guess it's more like a bayou setting, but, you know, I don't know. I think, like, that sort of journey, I think it fit well, is what I'm saying. The lyrics and the way it was sung, so. Fun. All right, let's jump into Kane Crazy, which is episode 3 of Amphibia. I actually have to pull up the episode now because I had something else pulled up because, yeah, we don't normally do things like this, but anyways, let's jump into episode 3 of Amphibia in... Or, sorry, episode 2A of Amphibia. It's messing with me because my files are individual. In 3, 2, 1, and... play. And here we go again with no lyrics. I like the visuals a lot, because the animation's, like, really good and stuff, but this song does nothing for me. It's cool, but, it's a cool OST, but for an OP, it does nothing for me. I don't know how much I like this song with lyrics, but I like it better. There it is. I love that logo. It's really pretty, like, in a weird way, like, in an amphibian way, I guess. Derek, was that Derek Kim Kim?
Wow, Anne, look at all your cool stuff. What's this? Ah, I get it. Torture device. That's a toenail clipper.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, sure. Oh,
I love Anne's voice so much. And I like how she's painful. Like, I mean, she's a little chipper, but she's not like that chipper for, like most Disney female protagonists are like really chipper.
This is amazing.
Wow.
You know what? You can keep it.
Kids, chow time!
Ew.
Time to eat! Time to eat!
Hold on, you kid. Hold on.
Yummy.
Ooh. You know what? I think I'm gonna pass.
Why? Is my food not good enough for the princess?
Ironic.
Well, if I'm the princess, then you're the king of bad cooking.
Oh, shit.
Oh.
Nice.
Oh, yeah. Well, you... I...
What's the matter, Hop Pop? Frog in your throat?
Damn. That's a good one.
Oh, dang it. You know what? I'm gonna take a nap. I don't believe this. I feed you, I house you, and this is how you repay me? If you don't shape up soon, Anne, I'm throwing you out.
Nice.
Yeesh. What's his problem? I'm Hop Pop, and I cook bad and have a temper problem.
That's so Hop Pop.
Nice.
Eat your aphids. Don't play with
them. Wow.
Off the table.
Wow.
Sometimes I wonder why I even bother putting up with you at all.
You idiot.
Oopsies. Guess I don't know my own strength, right, guys?
No.
You guys okay?
That was a mistake.
No deal. It's just one cane.
That wasn't just any cane.
It
was Hop Pop's special.
I didn't even talk about the title. It was either cane. It was like cane crazy.
His father, Hop and Lock, dropped Soppity Pop.
So much rhyming.
He's gonna kick me out the second he finds out about this. I cannot go back to living in a cave.
Yeah, that doesn't seem very fun.
The nights were the hardest.
Don't worry, Anne. We'll do whatever it takes to help you.
Count me out.
Polly!
What?
Yeah, she doesn't want any of that smoke.
Would you help me for one of these?
Ooh, Snickers.
Candy from another world!
I mean, I don't like Snickers,
Ladies,
but...
you got yourself a deal.
Glad to hear it. Now let's try to save my skin.
Nope.
Okay, maybe we can't fix it, but someone else can?
Yeah, someone you can find with someone.
Wood?
And you're a genius!
That's
we'll
pretty
just take you to Leopold
logical.
Woggle, the woodsmith.
Leopold
he
Loggle?
Loves wood. Almost a little too much.
Oh. Leopold Loggles, yeah.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah, he's getting a little turned on.
Fascinating as you are.
Yeah.
So can you fix it?
As a matter
yeah,
of fact, I can!
Very... Sir. Yeah.
Huh. Can you make a new one?
Absolutely!
Not.
No way.
Interesting. What's so special about
do
the cane?
You have one
besides it being
buy?
Like turn.
Of course I do!
Not. What? Well, doomed.
Old smithing accident. You don't want to know.
Okay, so.
Tripped on an anvil.
Wow.
Landed neck first on a metal pipe. Pierced my voice box clean through.
What the fuck?
Come on.
Cool.
Switched over to wood after that.
Nice.
Now, I'm afraid I can't do much for you. That cane was made with wood from the incredibly rare, extremely dangerous doom tree.
A doom tree, huh?
Few have made it to the doom tree alive. Fewer yet returned.
All
it
right.
holds many secrets that mortals dare not.
Dude, it's a tree. Just tell us where it is.
Yeah, Loggle, cut the chit-chat.
You're bald!
Damn, okay. Savage.
I got a map to the Doom Tree right here.
Oh, perfect. That's convenient. You.
Click.
Or you could do that.
Get fucked.
For free.
Come on, guys. We gotta hurry.
Get
Hop
dicked.
Hop could wake up at any second.
I mean, that picture doesn't look like you actually got
Be
the whole
careful,
thing, but...
you kids. It's cursed, I tell ya. Cursed!
To the Doom
it would
tree
be really funny if there was literally zero curses.
Whoa, Loggle. We gotta talk about this, man.
Yeah, I was staring right at it.
All right, goodbye.
Honestly, I don't think we want to talk about this, Sprig. Nice, nice. She went around, they went through. Very nice. Yum, yum. Wow, that's like a classic spot. I'm surprised it didn't go further than just to three levels.
We're here.
Sick, there's the Doom Tree. Time to get cursed.
That is an ugly tree.
Just one of Mother Nature's horrible mistakes.
Sure. Yeah. And that's dead guy.
Frogs died here.
What? Jesus Christ, Polly.
That branch is perfect.
Okay.
You people and your legs.
Oh, don't worry. You'll have some in time.
Careful. The tree is cursed. Okay, seriously, though, on three. One, two.
Yeah, it's cursed!
Did the tree just scream?
Yeah. Whoa. I mean, you got your cane, but, Oh, it's almost like, what the shit? Oh, it's not a tree at all! It's like a weird mantis thing.
Oh, hey, it's maple. Run!
Oh, or it's a maple tree. Interesting.
That thing is not a tree. It's some kind of grody bug.
A bug that wants to kill
or
us.
Or it's a maple tree. Maybe this is what maple trees really look like. Have any of you ever actually encountered a maple tree before? Ew. Nice. Close.
Well, Loggle, another day.
What is this fucking Stardew Valley music? What the fuck?
What the? What's going on?
Don't ask questions.
I mean, you got your cane.
What's it gonna take to get rid of this thing?
Ow. God damn, man.
Oh, this is nice.
What the fuck?
That took 20 years to carve.
Ooh. Oh, for a second I thought that was gonna be, I thought that was gonna be Hoppadiah, but instead it's the goat over here, Polly. Polly, wanna fight? Oh no, not sandpaper. Oh, no. That's rough, literally. Sick. Damn. Polly out here pretty beat. Oh no.
Why would a Witsmith have turned?
I was literally about to say that. Oh, I bet you are. Ew. Oh. Hey.
Cool. This world is messed up.
It's pretty fucked. Yeah, I guess that's kind of like being naked, question mark?
Up top.
We did it!
That was awesome, you guys!
What about the termites, though? What about the termites, though?
Give me that!
Hey!
What gives, Loggle?
I'll tell you what gives. This doesn't even begin to cover the damages you've caused to my shop.
True.
You're gonna have to give me something else. Come on, pony up.
Will this work?
What? What is this? Oh. Oh.
That's money. That's cash money right there. Just take it. They're already gone.
You can go.
They already took it. Yep.
Sorry, Anne.
Did you not take it?
All we worked for, too.
Oh, I thought you guys would have took it.
You'd better head home. Hop-Hop's probably already awake and furious.
Probably a bad time to bring this up.
You
but
stole
I still
it.
Get the candy, right?
Oh, okay. I was like, I was waiting for someone to say, hey, I stole it.
Oh, boy. I needed that. Hope nothing happened while I was asleep to make me mad again. Oh, no. What did you do?
What's up with canes? Who even needs them these days, am I right?
Ow. I'm really sorry, Hop Pop. I was goofing around and I broke your favorite cane.
You what?
I know. I'll show myself out.
We'll come visit you, Anne. We Aww. Promise.
And just when I was starting to like you.
Don't make this hard.
Man, you're already starting to like her in episode 2A.
What's going on?
You're throwing me out. You know, like you said you would.
And, truth be told, I was never gonna throw you out.
Aww.
I was just talking tough so that you'd show me a little bit more respect.
That's kind of messed up, man.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty normal. It's like what parents do, kind of.
A little bit too harsh.
Yeah, but honestly, not really.
When I was your age. Rough around the edges.
Cool.
Now put that bag down, young lady. You're not going anywhere.
Of course not.
Yeah, I like that.
I wasn't worried.
Thanks, Hop Pop.
Hell yeah.
So you're not mad about the cane?
Oh, I'm furious about the cane. You're on dish duty for a month.
Ooh. Yes, sir.
Yes.
Now that that's settled, I wrote a long list of comebacks to get you back for this morning. Hey, Anne, is that your hair, or is it a dandelion?
What the fuck?
Oh, are those long, lanky limbs, Anne, or are those twigs?
I mean, they kind of look like twigs.
The moment has passed, hasn't it?
Yeah, by quite a bit. I love the ED. I think the ED is perfect. This ED is very pretty. But the OP definitely could use some lyrics. And Disney and cut. Alrighty. That was episode 2A of Amphibia. That was either Kane Crazy or Crazy Kane. Actually, let me check before I go any further. That was Kane Crazy, yes. Okay, so that was a cute episode. We learned about Doom Trees, which are like weird creatures that I don't even know what to say about that guy or girl thing, whatever it was. But that was a cool episode. I definitely thought it was fun to see the three of them all working together and Sprague and Polly all, you know, united, even if that was because of bribe in the case of Polly, but all united together on the same cause. I'm a little disappointed they didn't just outright just steal the cane. I mean, obviously that would be a bad thing to do, so it's not what they should do, but I'm still kind of surprised that isn't what was done. But I guess given the narrative in the first episode, it kind of makes sense that maybe Anne would have done that then, but it didn't do it now. If anything, shows a bit of progression on her character already, so that's a good start, I suppose, for Anne, so maybe I'm wrong on that. That's kind of weird. It's like a loose hair there. And it's like white. It's like really annoying. But yeah, I did really enjoy that episode. It was a lot of fun. Not a lot to say, though. It was pretty basic. It was pretty... I mean, the main thing was we met Leopold. I don't know if Leopold's going to be like a very common recurring character or if he's going to be a pretty... like a one-off or maybe like a two or three-off character, but he's in my notes, so we'll see if Leopold shows up again. The Woodsmith definitely had an interesting backstory as to how he got into woodsmithing, but fun stuff. Yeah, I'm trying to think if I have anything else to say about this. I don't think I do, so we're probably going to jump into episode 2B, which is called Flood, Sweat, and Tears. Obviously, very obvious play on blood, sweat, and tears. Cool name, cool title. If they're dealing with a flood, that probably is going to be a little bit more serious. Probably going to be some bad stuff that comes out of that. So, yeah, in fact, I should actually double check before we go any further just to make sure. Okay, yeah, this set is, in fact, 2-4. I wanted to make sure because I actually wasn't 100% sure. I was pretty damn sure, but I wanted to check. So anyways, Blood, Sweat, and Tears. Let's see what that's all about. Like I said, obviously there's going to be a flood, and there's probably going to be there's probably going to be sweat and tears. Yeah, because I wouldn't expect blood necessarily in this show, but... Flood, sweat, and tears. That's all very much on the table for a show like Amphibia. So let's see some flood, some sweat, and some tears. I imagine it's not going to be that sad, though. You know, maybe later in the series, but for the time being, I don't expect anything to be that sad. So let's see what we got, though. Let's jump in to episode 2B of Amphibia in 3, 2, 1, and play. That island looks really cool. Like that outward look from above.
Hey,
Amphibia. Let's get it. Blood, sweat, and tears. Let's see what this is all about. Ah, Derek Kirk. Kim.
You ready? You set him up, and I'll knock him down.
Sounds like a plan. What's it, what actually are these?
Come on. Come on.
Oh, they're like eating the... Oh, those are big bugs.
Backhand.
Damn.
Nice swing. I was on varsity. I have no idea what that means.
I assume for tennis, obviously, but that was more base. That was more a baseball swing than a tennis swing. As I say, as those were probably the two sports I was best at.
So unnatural.
Psh, of course we get along. We're Sprig and Anne.
Anne and Sprig. Sprig against the world.
Disgusting.
Oh, Spriggan? Wow, that's funny.
Was that Hop Hop?
Sounds like he's in trouble. We're coming, Hop Hop! Hop Hop! Hop Hop! Whoa! What
I still can't tell if they're saying Hop Hop or Hop Pop or whatever. Yeah, there's a flood.
Stay back! Darn burrow bugs must have chewed the water pipes.
My room! My stuff!
Don't worry, Anne, I saved your stuff. Except your bed. And your blankets. And your pillow, pencils, t-shirt, hairbrush.
Just how long till it's fixed?
Well, gotta find the leak. Then patch it up good.
Oh, let me help.
Oh, no, you don't.
And then you gotta still gotta drain this shit.
No telling what creepy critters are swimming around.
Oh, yeah. I mean, that thing's eyes looked a little kawaii, but...
Well, the living room ain't no palace, but the couch is comfy.
Hello? Anne can bunk with me in my room. How fun will that be? Roommates? Heck yeah.
I don't know. Being friends is one thing, but roommates? You think you know someone until they're in your space. And you're in theirs, and you can't stand how they whistle all the time.
Damn.
And they
complain. Damn, you got some history.
And your web crusties out. Yes, I have to do it in our room. It has the best lighting.
Ooh.
My point is...
Yeah, that definitely sounds like past experience.
My words, though. No good will come of this. No good.
All right, I'll mark your words.
Here we have it. Whoa. Yep. Awesome dig, Sprig.
Thanks. I'll give you the grand tour.
Let's start with the crown jewels.
Oh, cool. A doll collection.
Don't call them dolls. Yep.
These are my action figures of the Great Battle
Incoming.
Of Barking.
Oh.
Damn.
Ooh. Sorry, dude.
What was that?
What? Haven't you ever had a pillow fight before?
Heads up. Oof.
Oh. It's on.
Nice. Oh, you better not break those, Anne. Oh, no. Oh, shit.
Oops. Just gonna move General Bog Breath safely over here.
Yeah, gotta keep that doll out of harm's way.
Time in.
Shouldn't you move all three of them? Okay, I guess not. Oh, night one. Oh,
so
God.
Sprig, would you rather sweat melted cheese or always smell like skunk? Sweat melted cheese. Frogs don't sweat, so I'd be cheese-free.
Frogs don't sweat?
Oh, blood, sweat, and tears. Okay.
Sprig?
Psst. Sprig. 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 Sprig.
Hey, Sprig!
Ah! You awake? Oh, yeah, totally. Okay, good. So next question.
Wow.
Melting.
Better. Freezing.
Oh my god, it's just gonna be... Wow. Wow.
Rise and shine, sleepyhead! You missed breakfast!
Go away.
First time
he's
I've
freaking
ever seen
light blue.
So
nice. This?
I froze solid in the night, and finally just thawed.
Nice!
What? It was like a swamp sauna in here. Maybe Sprig just needs another blanket.
Or maybe... Anne needs fewer blankets.
Or maybe...
No, couch is still free in case there's trouble in paradise.
No way, it's no
trouble. It's perfectly fine. We can totally sleep together.
We're the best roommates in the history of roommates.
Sprig against the world!
Yeah, roommates
After
is
you,
not
best
my...
Roommate.
Why, thank you, also best roommate.
Roommates is, if avoidable. Yeah,
absolutely.
100%. Oh my god, the freaking night one, night two. Just close your eyes, it's fine, bro. It's not, okay, that eating's a little sus, but... Okay, that didn't go too bad. That's a big oof there, nothing you can do about that. Oh, that's... And, of course, we're back to the classics here. Ew. Oh, yeah! Yeah, foreshadowing, I like it. Okay. Oh, shit. Diva, wow.
Is that my shirt?
Hey, I mean, Sprig's a diva. What else can you say?
How much longer you think? Tonight?
Not a chance.
Oh, let me help. You know my underwater sight is better than yours.
That's a bunch of malarkey. My eyesight's fine. Who's that, Sprig? Anyway, wow. Don't you have chores to do?
Hey, Hop-Hop, what's the ETA on things down here? Oh, you know, not that I'm in a hurry to move back in or whatever. What? I'm just curious. A girl can't ask about her flooded makeshift bedroom without getting grilled? Sheesh.
Damn. I mean, to be fair, he did give her the grill eyes, but still.
Wow, what a long day. Going straight to bed if I can get there without tripping over all these dirty clothes.
Yeah, I think it's your wet towels on the ground that'll get in your way.
I can leave my towels on the floor of my room.
What was that?
Oh,
oh God.
Nothing best, roomie.
Anyways. About to break the general or something? No? That honestly looked like... How are you still... How do you still have charge?
Aw. Hey, Sprig. Would you rather have a splinter you can never get out? Or get bit by a giant mosquito once a day forever? Hey, Sprig.
Oh, no.
What in?
Pillow fight! No, wait, stop!
Oh, shit. Oh, for fuck's sake. For fuck's sake!
Oh, no! Your doll! I mean, action figure. Sprig against the world, right?
I have to go to the bathroom.
Scream coming?
How is it still so hot in here?
Where's that darn leak? Come on, come on.
Oh, that leak has got to be around here somewhere.
I know, right?
Wow.
What are you doing here?
I was, feeling like a nighttime swim. What are you doing here?
Same.
Swim?
Yeah.
You came down here to fix the leak.
Yeah, well, so did you.
I knew it. You just couldn't wait to move out.
And you just couldn't wait to get rid of me.
Oh, shit.
You wanted me gone. You should have just said so.
And?
Yeah,
and,
time to save her.
And.
Yeah, you guys could not work.
Hang on.
Just because you don't work together as roommates doesn't mean you guys aren't best friends. Don't worry about it. Yeah, I still argue the eyes are kind of cute, but that thing is pretty horrifying. The monsters in this show are wild.
Giver lampreys. What are we gonna do?
Giver lampreys?
We can't
what?
Them underwater.
Oh.
Huh. Hey, Sprig. You set him up?
I knock
you
him down.
You knock him down.
Yep. Right out of the park. Well, that... What the hell? I was about to say, is that a fusion dance? I was not far off. Yo.
Backhand!
Damn, she's badass. Gotta love some Anne beatdown.
Had enough, river losers?
There's more where that came from.
I'm waiting for Hopadiah to just show up and be like, what the hell is all this ruckus? Oh. Well, that works.
What the heck's going on down here?
Some of us are trying to sleep!
Nightmare.
Hi, Hop-Hop.
So, roommate thing didn't work out, huh?
Not really.
I just couldn't live with him. The wet towels, the heat, the humidity, the web crusties.
The loud snacking, the freezing cold, lights on at all hours. Guess Sprain really is a bust.
Yeah.
Mm.
Why? Because you're finally talking? Sharing a room doesn't make you friends. Being
sure.
honest with each other does.
Yep.
In fact, if you ask me, you're better friends now than you were before.
Yeah, part of a friendship is
of
accepting
course we
the
are. Yes,
good, the bad, and the ugly,
and
right?
Better than before.
And of course, they have a weird best friend handshake.
Oh, sweet. So where is Anne gonna sleep then? Not with me. My bucket's for one.
Couch it is.
Here you go. So
some super loud snacks you can munch on.
Oh, thanks, Sprig.
No problem. Anything else I
can
get?
Hey, at least she likes the snacks.
See you in the AM.
Whatever the hell they are.
Good night.
She's just gonna fall asleep now? What's the problem, girl? Oh my god, they're gonna talk.
So, Anne, would you rather smell like rotten eggs or have hiccups every day for the rest of
your
life?
Oh, rotten eggs.
Good one.
Oh, rotten eggs, 100%.
Didn't anyone fix the leak?
Nope. Get fucked. It would be so funny if the leak was like an ongoing arc, quote unquote, for like 5 episodes or something. That's where Rough Draft Korea is involved in, like, all of these shows. Alrighty. That was Amphibia, episode 2B now. Yeah, I mean, I think I liked that episode a little more than 2A. It was cute. We got some good value out of Anne and Sprig's interactions. I thought they had a lot of really cute stuff there. We got to see them go through a few trials and tribulations as friends. And I think that's, obviously it's all been very minor stuff so far. But I'm already picking up a theme with Sprig and Anne's relationship. Even though it's being put to the test in very small doses, it's already being put to the test constantly in this show, which makes me think that later on down the line, it's really going to be tested. I imagine it'll have something to do with Sasha and Marcy, and there'll be a deal where, I don't know, maybe Anne, gives in to peer pressure or something, does something that she probably shouldn't, and it hurts Sprig in some way, or I don't know exactly what, but in some form or another, their friendship's going to be tested, and there might be a point in time where they're like divided and they're no longer friends or whatever, and there's already a lot of narrative foreshadowing to that because they're strengthening their bonds and they're already testing their friendships a lot and through little means, which will strengthen their friendship, strengthen their bond, which only escalates the type of thing that would be necessary to rip them apart. But knowing shows like this, I won't be surprised if we get to that point. Early observations, but something to look out for. Fun episode. I definitely did enjoy it. Like I said, I think it was probably a tiny bit better than the last one. I mean, neither of them were anything crazy. And again, I'm not really expecting too much out of this set. And really, for a little while, we're chilling right now. We're just getting interested and invested in the universe. But it was cool. It was cool. You know, we had a flood. We got to have roommates. They spent a bunch of time, basically like 2 weeks together. And at night, and we got to see some of their tendencies. Sprig likes it warm, Anne likes it cool. I think I trend more towards Anne. I like it cool. I mean, I can manage no matter what. But you know, like let's get that cool there. I'm down for that. But I can go either way, of course. But yeah, I mean, it's interesting to see. How I'm kind of assuming that most of the episodes are going to be, obviously I expect we'll get focused on Hapadaya, we'll get focused on Polly and stuff, but I do expect most of the episodes to center around Sprig and Anne's relationship, because that does seem like the focal point of the series. It reminds me a little bit of Adventure Time. It really does kind of feel like a little bit like a Finn and Jake dynamic. And you even kind of have a similar deal where, you know, it's like, it's a fantastical world and you have the main character who's the human and their best friend, of course, is not a human. Now, obviously, with Finn and Jake, it's a much different dynamic because they've known each other, you know, for a very long time as opposed to Sprig and Anne where they're newfound friends. But it's an interesting dynamic and that's kind of what this is reminding me of. And the show in general. Reminding me a little bit of early Adventure Time. Now, what I think Adventure Time had over Amphibia was Adventure Time was fucked. Even early weird... Adventure Time is so weird all the way through. But Adventure Time was, even at the beginning, was weirdly fucked up. And Amphibia has not been anything on that degree. But the charm and the kind of nature of it reminds me a little bit of early Adventure Time. Now, again, Adventure Time, in my opinion, one of the best shows ever made. I don't think Amphibia... That's like the absolute best case scenario. I've watched plenty of cartoons before and quite a few after Adventure Time. And at the very least, on the latter of the two, on the after part, I don't think anything's reached that level. Well, maybe something. Oh, man. Anyways, I'm curious to see where it goes, though. Fun episode. Not a whole lot to say. I feel so weird because I recorded the My Hero Academia, and I feel like in this current arc of My Hero, I don't have much to say. And now we're in, like, these early Amphibia episodes where, you know, we're getting character development, we're getting world building, that fun stuff, but there's not really a lot for me to break down, and it feels really weird to do two reactions in a row where I don't have a lot to say. So I can't wait until Amphibia gives me stuff that I have a lot more to say about, or, like, My Hero gets out of the current arc, because it's like, because there's slots 3 and 4 in the rotation, so they come back to back, so it's kind of awkward. Anyways, episode 3A is called Hop Luck. So, yeah, Hop Luck. Well, obviously hopping, that could be referring to anyone in this show, because they're all frogs or whatever. Something to do with luck. Yeah, it could be interesting. That could be about anyone, so I'm curious to see what that'll be about. So let's jump into episode 3A of Amphibia, Hop Luck in a Flash. Alrighty, let's jump into Hop Luck, episode 3A of Amphibia in 3, 2, 1, and play. I could start like 30 seconds into the episode, but the intro is so short that there's kind of no point to skip it, honestly. And it's charming. I like watching it. Even if I still stand by the song that they should have went with the lyrical version of the song. But I'm sure that's not a hot take. I'm sure most of you guys agree. I mean, it's cool, though. Like, I like it as an OST. That's my thing. Like, this would be a cool theme in for the show, but not for the actual OP. We have not met almost any of those. I honestly didn't even see Leopold in that shot at the end of the OP. But we've met basically none of those potatoes.
And this bad boy is my kitty Domino. You guys with
Domino.
She's got fire.
Ooh. Aw, she's so tidy. I feel huge!
I will set her free!
Please stop doing that.
Oh, what is that? Did something crawl under the house and die?
They don't like the smell.
Worse, Anne. Much worse. Pop is cooking.
Oh no, not again.
Brace yourself.
Brace myself for what?
I mean, we already seen him cook, but apparently this is like a million times worse. Oh, jeez.
What's the plan this year, Hop Pop? Poison the competition?
The plan is to win.
Win?
The annual village potluck. Every year, we frogs gather for a great contest. The
family brings the best tasting dish and shower
with love and copper coins. The family with the worst tasting dish spends the night in the same cage.
Brutal.
And guess which family ends up there every year?
Maybe Anne can cook?
If you think I'm gonna let my favorite froggy family end up in a cage,
favorite froggy
you've got
family.
Another thing coming.
FFF.
I know I'm not technically a planter, but maybe I can help.
And we'd sure appreciate it.
So, what you making over there, Hot Pop? Sock gumbo?
No, silly. It's a traditional recipe from my family's cookbook. We've been using the old ways, since I was a polywog.
I like how it looks like a snail.
I think I found your problem, guys. Old things are dumb.
Damn!
Oh, that makes sense.
It's all so clear now.
Wow, the kids agree.
We planners have always cooked these recipes. What
and
would my
you've always
Gam-Gam
been losing.
Say?
She'd say move on.
She was a fierce woman.
Look, If we're gonna win this thing, we need something new. Something revolutionary. Something no one in the swamp has ever seen before. Something like... pizza.
Whoa.
Pizza, not JPEG.
I love it.
Pizza is the ultimate dish. You haven't lived until you've shared one with your friends at the mall.
Now, hold on. Before we get
you'd have to make
away,
like a bug pizza or something, but recipe. Why not?
Swamp mold pot pie.
Pizza! Pizza!
Okay.
We'll win for sure with this, Hop Pop.
Now all we gotta do is...
Oh my god,
all
stop.
We gotta do is get four ingredients. Dough, cheese, basil, and tomatoes. Are you guys ready to make our pizza dreams a pizza reality?
Pizza dreams!
Oh, maybe we should put pineapple on it. Seems like
that's
a don't you dare talk about pineapple on my pizza. Ever.
She's one of those.
Okay, let's go get those ingredients.
So I am a massive pizza fan and a massive pineapple fan. I don't think it's a crime to put pineapple on pizza, but I actually am not the biggest pineapple pizza fan.
If you want the dough, the boy has to marry my daughter.
Yes.
Ice
oh, yes. Oh, yes, I found my new favorite character.
Adorable.
Done.
You know, if we used a traditional recipe, we wouldn't have to sell Sprig.
No, that old book is old. Sprig's eternal happiness is a small price to pay
true.
For pizza.
True.
Agreed.
It's not so bad. Maybe we'll learn to love each other.
I've seen your death in my mind.
Whoa.
I was kind of hoping it'd be a surprise.
What's your...
It will be.
Oh!
Congratulations
oh,
on
I
your
love
new
her.
Son. Now cough up the dough.
Congratulations on your new son.
You're doing business with ya.
Is that what you just said?
Well, looks like we gotta go. See ya.
I wanna be the maid of honor.
See you soon, hubby.
I hope that goes somewhere. Oh, there's that lady from the end of the OP.
Thanks again for helping me out. I know Brutus
Harper
can be
there,
a
yeah.
handful.
Oh, for the cheese.
What are we here for again? Cheese!
You know, there's a recipe in here that doesn't need cheese.
No old recipes! Huh?
Oh, man, I want some pizza.
Hey, Brutus, over here!
Even the music's...
Toro.
Wow, Toro. We got the Matador music and everything. Well, sort of Matador music. The Amphibia's ex-Matador.
Yeah.
There you go, dearie. A hunk of cheese made fresh from the milk of those cows.
Please don't tell me where it comes from.
Yeah, I mean, it'll be like a swamp pizza. Basil.
Hey, careful with that basil, dude. We had to fight off like 10 giant aphids to get it.
Who knew ultimate flavor could be so painful?
Yeah, you'd be surprised.
Behind those things.
This is the price of progress, Hop-Hop. Exactly, and we've only got one ingredient left. Tomatoes. According to this, they should be up ahead.
Still can't believe I traded my favorite dentures for that map.
You know, I've nice. Never actually tasted a tomato. No one in town really sells them.
There's a reason for that. Oh. They're in the dangerous vegetable oh, section.
Of course they
it
are.
I suggest we go for prunes instead. Can't go wrong with prunes.
Whoa. Dangerous vegetables? Come on.
You'd be surprised, girl. Girl clearly never played Mario.
Holy
tomato.
Oh.
You know, this baby's got some great substitutes. All of which are delightfully harmless.
Couldn't hurt to hear a few options.
Hold on. Guys, the shame cage isn't just in the town square. It's up here.
Damn,
we're
that's deep.
We're not gonna
deep.
Change the world without taking a few risks.
True.
We need to be bold, groundbreaking, brave.
And there's a big difference between courage and stupidity.
Wild time to save. Oh my god.
Hop-up!
Well, that was a thing that just happened. Oh geez, it's gonna be. Oh, never mind. Oh, they're gonna have to fight from inside. Okay. Well, luckily, this thing doesn't use its damn teeth.
Holy smokes! Acid.
Well, at least the ingredients are safe.
Well.
No! The ingredients! Everything we've worked for!
At least it'll be a quick, painless death.
Why would this be painless?
Just let me have this lie!
Yeah, it's acid.
My revolutionary ideas were supposed to save you guys, not get you killed. I shouldn't have been so stubborn. I just really wanted to share a pizza with you guys.
I didn't care about that pizza stuff anyway. But you were really trying to help this family out.
Yeah, that's so it matters.
Worth something in my
book. Sure.
Your book? That's it? Is there anything in the old ways that could help us right now?
Well, I don't know. Nothing especially useful. Just that the throat of this giant tomato plant is absolutely delicious eaten raw.
Oh! Nice! Hey, turnabout's fair play. You eat us, we eat you. Oh, God. Oh, Jesus. Okay, that was a bit dark. Not Adventure Time dark, but a bit.
Know your place, plant!
There isn't much time. Let's go literally home and make one of your old recipes, Hop.
No, just bring the tomatoes.
Maybe we can spruce it up with something a little dangerous.
Yeah, tomatoes, not prunes.
Yep,
what the
still
fuck?
Still up here. Still need help.
Okay.
Put it right over here.
Just a little touch of goodness.
A few more bug legs should do it.
Is that fly going to stay up there?
Nice.
Perfect.
All right.
Hello.
Let's
do it. Potluck tasting.
Let's get to tasting those dishes. That is scrumptuous. Oh, what have we here?
Those are a weird fly thing.
Delicious. Yes, excellent effort at last, but not least, the planters. What filth have you cooked up this time?
I thought he was going to say what tomato. Fuck shit.
Awfully dangerous. I do declare, this is the best dish the
Let's go!
Has ever brought to a potluck.
That could still be worse.
What? Did we do
that
it?
That doesn't mean
win?
No.
But the tomato is good.
Than usual, but it's still terrible. Last place, as
usual.
Hey,
the tomato made it good. Yep, the tomato made it better.
All right, boys, light it up.
Jesus. And that was the best dish they'd ever cooked.
Cheer up, guys. Sure, we came in last. Again. But thanks to Anne's new ideas and Hop Pop's old ones, we've done the best we've ever done.
You know, he's right.
Yeah, we did, didn't we?
Oh, you're going into.
This is weird, but any chance I could squeeze in there?
How about it, Carl?
The more the merrier.
Of course.
Hear that?
Get in here, you crazy kid.
Woo-hoo! Yeah, just cross it. Yeah. Hell yeah.
Well, if we can't share a pizza, at least we can share this.
Hey, you know, all together in the shame cage.
Hey, what the heck? What was that? Ooh, I forgot to mention the shame nuggets.
Well, luckily you guys are so high that these...
Hey, that's my son-in-law.
Hey. I hope that's...
Is that the best you got?
Damn. I hope that's not just a one-episode gag. Oh, damn. Nice. Yeah, suddenly, when you get hit in the face with something, suddenly tradition doesn't seem as cool, does it? Hop Pop. It is Hop Pop. Okay. Thank you, credits, for making my life a little bit easier. Shout out to TJ Hill. It's a pretty good sound, a pretty good score. That's so adorable. Oh, man, I love it. I love it. All right, that was 3A of Amphibia. We'll jump into 3B in a second, but let's talk a little bit about Hopluck. It was a potluck, but it was a hopluck because Amphibia, frogs, hopping, Keck W, pretty basic stuff. That was a pretty good episode. The hunt for pizza, it did make me just a tiny bit hungry. I'm probably not going to eat anything for a while. I had dinner a while ago. I had dinner a lot earlier than normal. I had dinner like at a regular time as opposed to super late like I normally do. Usually this would be around the time I'd have dinner. So it's not too late, but it's like close to 9 o'clock, I think. Or it might actually already be 9. I don't know. I can't see the time at this moment. But it was, pizza sounded great. Hopefully the planter family get to have some pizza down the line. That would be great. You know, that'd be a great moment, just everyone eating pizza. You can't go wrong with pizza. Definitely gives me... Although, when I think of pizza in, like, cartoons, it kind of makes me think of Teen Titans a little bit. Because there was definitely some pizza lovers in that group. And obviously, that's a series I reacted to not really all that long ago, to be honest. So, that's pretty fresh in my mind. But, yeah, I definitely enjoyed that episode. Honestly, that was probably one of the best episodes so far. Not that that's a super high bar, because there hasn't been, like, any amazing episodes yet. There hasn't been a standout episode yet, I will say. I don't think there's been a standout episode of the show just yet. But maybe we'll get one before the end of this set. We'll have to see. It's been fun so far. I'm into it. And I'm curious to see where we go with that, because I like building the family dynamic a lot. Like I said, the main focus seems to be Sprig and Anne, but we're getting a lot of just the overall family dynamic. I think Hop Pop, in particular, getting a lot of sauce. Polly feels like the fourth out of the group, but yeah, it's cool. It's cool. I'm trying to think of anything else to say about that one. I definitely... do enjoy fighting tomatoes. I think that's pretty fun. You know, it's, you know, I like tomatoes, but they're usually not worth the effort when you have to, you know, kill them like that. But, you know, they're cool. I do like tomatoes. Curious to see if they ever have to fight tomatoes again. I imagine they won't, but you never know. Who knows? Maybe that'll be the final boss of Amphibia. It'll be like the Mega Tomato. But yeah, we met a couple characters. I didn't write down any names, but we got to interact with a couple of the townsfolk in this episode, which was also cool. Curious to see more of them, see what fun stuff we do with them. We got like the Dairy Girl, and there was a few other potatoes. But yeah, I'm actually not tired. I don't know why I'm like kind of yawning. But anyways, we have episode, this will be 3B. And it's called Stakeout. Okay, this could be fun. I don't really know why we would be doing a stakeout or what that would be for, honestly. So yeah, I don't really have a prediction for anything here. Maybe this could be the first touch of one of the other girls, like human girls. I doubt it. I feel like they're gonna wait until, like, I don't know if we have a mid-season finale, but I feel like they're gonna wait either to a mid-season finale or potentially even the season one finale to give us a big thing with Sasha and Marcy, if not Sasha or Marcy. And yeah, I feel like they're gonna take a while to get into that, because I feel like that's going to play into whatever the main plot of Amphibia is. It's going to have to do with those two girls. But we'll see. We'll see how long it takes for them to show up in an actual capacity beyond the tease we got at the beginning. But let's, yeah, but you know, episode 1B, I guess. So yeah, let's jump into 3B. Season 1, episode 3B of Amphibia in 3, 2, 1, and play. Oh, I love that shot. Also, toads walking snails like horses is pretty funny. Or pets in general. We haven't seen any of these creatures yet, but of course with these OPs, a lot of the times, none of it actually comes up in the actual show. That's gonna come up, though. Okay, now we've actually met a lot of those people, because also the girl, and we don't know her name, I didn't hear it at least, but the girl that is the future wife of Sprig.
All I'm saying is that where I'm from, you could get arrested for having a couch this firm.
Back in my day, we didn't have furniture. We sat on rocks. Sharp ones.
Nice.
Okay,
gotta love
rocks.
If
I get butt blisters, I'm blaming you.
Back in my day, we called those character.
Character, nice.
Oh, so heavy.
Mind the flagstone. Back in my day, kids spent less time complaining and more time watching their step.
Yeah, well, where I'm from, people fixed their crummy houses.
This house is like family. You apologize.
To a house?
Yeah.
Where I'm from, we didn't rush people in the bathroom.
Well, back in my day, we didn't have a bathroom.
Of course.
Stop hitting the door with a battering ram.
It's been 2 hours.
Damn, well, 2 hours
is
take this anymore. Fair point.
They're just getting used to each other. It's not a big deal.
Not a big deal? Do you remember the Hendersons next door? They used to argue all the time. And look what happened to them.
Jesus.
Nothing like scavenging the remains of a broken frog family.
Broken frog family, huh?
If we don't do something now, it won't be long before their bickering tears this family apart.
I still think we should just give them time. Not like we have a lot of options. You can't force
So they're gonna stake out those two? Ann and Hot Pop?
Of course not, Polly.
What the fuck? Oh, that's terrifying.
Of course not.
Oh, God. What are you about to do, Sprig? And of course, Polly.
Of course, let's go already!
Yeah, Polly doesn't care.
We've been robbed!
Say what?
Sorry. It's just that Hop Hop delivered the perfect sitcom catchphrase.
Must be painful to make so little sense all the time.
Wow.
My prize-winning corn.
Oh, shit.
You won prizes?
It's an expression, Anne. What are you doing, please?
The injustice, the outrage. We've got to catch this thief.
Agreed. And it's nice to see you so passionate about produce, Sprig.
Yes.
Produce passion.
Very odd.
If the thief stole once, it'll steal again. The only way to catch this monster.
I mean, yeah, I guess most likely.
I like steak.
Good idea.
Okay.
I'd like steak too. I actually had steak for dinner today. First time in a while.
Stand it up, Bob.
Say what?
Well, I obviously can't because I have the attention span of,
Oh, look at that. Why not Hop Hop and Polly? Seems like a winning combo to me.
Polly's a baby, Anne.
Just asking, Hop Hop.
Very well. Let's be honest, though. Anne'll probably fall asleep and it'll just be me.
Why would I fall asleep first? Aren't you like 100 years old?
I'm a crisp 68.
You stole the cord, didn't you?
Oh, absolutely. But now those two have to spend the whole night together and bond.
You're just gonna make it worse, you idiot.
You can't manipulate people like this.
I can, and I did. And it's going to save
this He definitely did manipulate people like this. I don't know if he's gonna get anything out of it, except for making things worse.
Just look at him. And now to watch the flowers of friendship bloom.
Oh, Sprig trying to level up.
For goodness sakes, Ann, put that lamp out. We're trying to catch the thief, not scared away. Had a feeling you wouldn't last.
Worry about yourself. I'll be fine. I just need a little boost is all.
Lamberry Blitz.
Lamberry Blitz. The drink that punches you in the face and doesn't stop. Ha! That silly drink won't keep you up. Now this will keep you up.
What is this poison?
Mama's old gourd tea recipe. I'm not surprised you don't like the smell. It's way too strong for you.
No way it's stronger than my berry blitz.
Swap.
Give me that.
Oh, shit. They're both gonna die.
You should have seen the look on your face. You were dying.
And what about you? I didn't even know you could turn that color.
Actual bonding.
Well, you got chameleon in your blood.
That's a good one, actually. Aw. I would drink a blamberry blitz.
Sometimes I wonder if I'll ever get home.
I know what it's like to miss something, Ann. I find myself pining after the good old days way too much.
Yeah. We're kind of similar that way. You're always going on about the old days. I'm always going on about back home.
Yeah, deep down, we're just a couple of softies, ain't
we? Aww. Wow, that's actually working.
They're connecting.
Of course, my situation is way worse than yours.
God damn it. What the fuck,
always gotta make it about you, don't you?
Honestly.
And my life is worse than everyone else's.
Pretty much.
Oh, yeah?
I mean, it kind of is,
my head
but...
isn't a tea kettle. Wait, what?
Oh, God. Oh, yeah? It's actual
at least
drugs.
My hair isn't rainbow stardust.
Oh, actual drugs in those drinks? What the hell?
What's happening to us?
How should I know? Oh, the drinks. Our body chemistry must be so different that we're having crazy reactions to each other's extreme beverage. Okay, that was the smartest sounding thing I've ever said.
Honestly, that was pretty intelligent.
I never
body chemistry is coming.
Trying something new.
Oh, yeah? Well, your gross old mama's tea did this to me. Oh, no, this can't be. They're fighting again.
I love how it looked like they were miming. Yeah.
Okay. No,
God, Sprig, you idiot.
We just have to take matters into our own hands.
Polly, knock him out.
Oh, that's right, Polly. I'm going to steal more corn right under their noses.
Oh, my God.
We'll have to do this again tomorrow and the next night and the next
what
night.
What is wrong with you?
Until they're the bestest friends who were ever friends, and then the family will be saved.
Yeah, we're all going to be dead in a week.
Try and stop me.
2 weeks, it'll be third impact.
Oh, boy.
I didn't make you drink my berry blitz.
Well, you grabbed for my tea first.
This wasn't my fault.
Well, it sure wasn't mine.
It was neither your fault, but it was his fault.
The corn thief.
Watch where you're pointing that thing.
Sorry.
Nice. Oh, yeah, these two are going to be the best at teaming up.
Stop this madness!
Let's go!
You've lost your mind!
A small price for saving this family!
Hey!
Stop right there, you... you... thief?
Huh? Oh, Jesus.
Whoa.
They're literally tripping balls. I do appreciate how it didn't take many episodes for us to start tripping balls.
The corn thief! And it's the scariest thing I've ever seen!
Finally, something we agree on!
We got to take this thing down. Are you with me?
Oh my God.
Till the end.
Let's kick Sprig's ass. This will be hilarious. Hopefully, Polly doesn't get. Tea kettle beam! And rainbow magic all together. What the fuck?
The attacks have no effect.
But we can't.
Because you're literally not attacking. Just casual.
Well, they're broken.
It must be immune to magic.
Quick, grab those power-ups.
Power-ups?
Oh, God. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Imagine just murder. That would be a good plot twist. Actually about to murder your ass.
Man, Hop Hop, it's me. I've learned my lesson, I promise. I'll never manipulate.
Does the corn thief kind of sound like Sprig to you?
Now that you mention it.
Nice.
Don't kill me, please.
Huh?
Hey, back to normal. Nice.
Wait, why? None of that was real.
Don't kill
but it was so terrifying.
Please.
I thought we were goners.
Me too. And you defended me.
Yeah, you two worked together. Hell yeah. There you go.
True warrior.
Yes.
You know, Hop Pop, back home, we call that having a friend's back.
Hey.
Well, back in my day, we called it pulling a Stinky McGuire.
What?
If you don't know Stinky, the saying don't mean much. So let's just stick with yours.
Yeah. Boy, although I'd love to meet Stinky McGuire in a flashback, maybe.
Wow, Sprig, I owe you an apology. Your double plan actually kind of worked.
Thanks, Paul.
You also almost
well, maybe
died.
Next time, we do it your way.
Yeah, it's probably for the best.
Guess I should drag them inside. But first, I'm parched.
No. Oh, she's just gonna. Nice.
All right, boo. soldier trod. You ready?
Wait.
To roll?
Oh, she did that on purpose.
Always my queen.
Good man, Boulder Trot. Good man.
What the fuck? That's hilarious. I love it. Always my queen. Yeah, we'll cut this one a little early here. That'll do it for... That was episode 3, or, 3B. Of Amphibia. That was Stakeout. That was another one of the best episodes. Again, good fun stuff. It's weird with these because it's hard because there hasn't really been any like bad episodes. There hasn't really been any like really good episodes. I feel like they've all been like all right. Again, still no standout episodes, but that was a fun episode. That gave us a dynamic between Daddy, Hoppadiah, and Anne, and that was fun. I enjoyed that. Not a whole lot else to say, really. It was fun. I'm curious to see where their relationship goes, because they're kind of the stubborn potatoes, although I guess they kind of, all four of them, kind of have stubborn tendencies when I really think about it, so... I guess that's what kind of makes Anne fit right into the family, if we're being completely honest here. But, yeah, that was a fun episode. That was pretty cute. I Gourd Tea and Mama's Gourd Tea and Blitzberry Blast or whatever it was called. Yeah, sounds like a combination to get fucked up. Yeah, fun episode. Fun episode. I enjoyed it a fair bit. And I hope you guys enjoyed it as well. I guess with these, it's kind of mostly the reaction, because like I said, I haven't had a ton to say in like the post-game commentaries, but I guess that's fine. They are shorter episodes. There's literally less content than what we get in most shows anyways per episode, so it kind of makes sense. I don't have a lot to say unless something crazy is going down, and really not much as far as like crazy has actually gone down. Anyways, though, episode 4A is called The Domino Effect. Now... that's a pretty intriguing title, so it implies that we're going to get a chain of events that, you know, so one event is going to set off a domino effect, and set off a chain of events based on whatever that first initial event is. The thing with these titles is I really can't make good... They're not very much prediction-y titles, so I haven't really been able to, like, really assume anything, and we don't really have, like, anything, like, super crazy going on to really give me a read on potentially what the potential, like, sauce is for a prediction for these titles, but I'm definitely interested to see where it goes, and yeah, I guess we'll have to find out, so fun times. Fun times. I just want to check something real quick. All right, so yeah, we're gonna be jumping in to episode 4A of Amphibia, season 1. In a flash. Alrighty, time to jump into episode 4A of Amphibia, The Domino Effect, in 3, 2, 1, and play. I didn't actually look at the title there when I looked over here. I literally just went over to press play, but I was waiting to say the name. I couldn't think of the name for a second, even though I just talked about it, just looked at it. Because, like, I immediately went back, you know, turned this back on right after the last cut. No more cuts in this episode, though. Well, at least no more foreseen cuts. Let's get it. Amphibia. The Domino Effect, already.
bada.
Oh, now you're actually doing baseball. Wow. That's a big-ass weird melon thing.
Sprig!
Murder time. And the domino effect has begun. What the hell?
Want to go again?
Yeah!
Wait, you have hair?
Yeah.
Sorry about your hat. Oh, there it is!
The domino effect has begun.
Do you hear something?
How did you get your hat back, by the way?
Something's in trouble!
It sounds like a cat.
Oh my gosh! We have to save her! Right behind you!
Maybe.
Gotcha!
Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus.
Oh, gotta go!
Those are giant wasps.
Take that,
damn.
Brains! Go someone your own size.
Or maybe that is the domino effect. Am I saving that cat thing? Bug cat
now,
thing?
Little fella. What's wrong? Are you stung?
Does it remind you of Domino?
No.
Oh, Domino effect!
Exactly like
Domino,
Domino
was the cat name. Oh, I'm an idiot. I'm an idiot. I totally forgot.
Anything in the world.
Oh,
was irreplaceable.
Double meaning title.
Let's take her home.
Oh,
with
this
us.
Is clever.
I don't know, Anne.
I feel so stupid
sure
for forgetting her name was Domino.
That's ridiculous.
Not this.
My cat back home
cat,
was destroyed
yeah.
before I adopted her. All it takes is love and patience and. Love?
You said love twice. Sold!
It's
nice.
Settled! I hereby dub the Domino 2.
Oh, really?
Come on, girl. Let's go home.
Is it broken?
Hold up. I got an idea. This worked on Domino 1 without fail.
Wow. It's literally like a cat.
That's it, girl. You can do
it's
it.
It's a caterpillar. Oh, kill me now. I hate my life. I should have never came back from hiatus.
Hey, Hot Pop, old buddy,
I'm
old
joking,
pal.
Of course.
What do you want, Anne?
Oh, nothing. I was just thinking, doesn't this house feel empty to you?
Not especially.
Wouldn't it be nice to have a sweet, fuzzy, loving critter around?
A pet?
Great idea, Hot Pop.
No pets. Every time we get one, Sprig and Polly swear they're gonna take care of it. Like this one spider we had, Charlie Big Bottom. I mean,
Charlie
sure,
Big Bottom,
they were there
uh-huh.
for all the cuddling and the snuggling, but who gets stuck doing all the work? Good old Hop Pop, that's who. I swear to Frog, whoever brings a fuzzy critter into this house will be on dung duty for a month. I told Charlie Big Bottom, stay out of the...
Plan B. We're gonna have to sneak Domino 2 inside.
Should we be concerned about this?
That is called play biting.
Or it's a vampire.
It yeah, kinda seems like she's tasting me.
That's ridiculous. Trust me, I know cats.
Well, that's not a cat.
Right, if you say so.
That's not a cat, and it just looks like one.
Not to go up the chimney. And that little spider look at me with those big green eyes like he understood me. 2 minutes later, where do I find him? Up the chimney. What's that?
Hey, Hop Hop. What's the worst thing Charlie Big Bottom ever did since we're talking about Charlie Big Bottom?
How can I even choose? Jumping out
wow.
in front of Bessie and overturning the wagon. Getting tarantula hair everywhere. Then there was a time she put a hole in the roof.
Where'd that happen again?
You blind. The big hole right there.
I don't see it.
Nice.
Right there.
What the fuck? Did you really need to do the evil laugh at the end?
You're awake.
Guess it wasn't that Anne? Evil, but... Oh, no, she's dead.
Anne!
No, she's
Anne?
Dead. She's
Anne?
Gone.
Anne!
No longer part of the series.
Anne! Hey, wake up, wake up!
Huh?
What happened? Are you okay?
Hmm? Yeah, totally. Domino 2 just had a bit of a rough first night indoors.
Fuck.
Hop Up is definitely gonna notice something.
Oh, this is nothing. We just have to keep an eye on her while she's adjusting.
Isn't that right, Domino 2?
Oh, God.
That's just how she says I love you.
Caterpillar, almost closer to a spider. What the fuck? Oh, that's adorable. I wonder if Domino 2 is going to end up being the biggest villain they've faced so far, or if they're actually going to be able to. Or if they're actually going to... Oh, no, is going to be gone?
Oh, forgot the mustard.
Wow. Or is Domino 2 actually going to end up being their pet in the end? Yeah, this thing is a literal demon. This is actually really sad because it shows how much Anne is feeling homesick. Because I feel like, I mean, she's not like the smartest girl in the world, but I feel like she's smarter than that. Oh no, is it gonna get bigger?
It's all worth it when you get to watch your adorable little boo take a nap.
I gotta admit, she's pretty darn cute.
Welcome, brother, to the Church of Cute.
This, cult thing?
Whoa. Looks like Domino 2 isn't the only one.
Why did I have to think of... I was about to say the initials of the Church of Cute, and then I realized what it is. Someone needed to oh, yeah, it's gonna evolve. Someone needs to realize that that literally is just caught.
Hello there! Hungry much?
We've been running around all day. We're starving.
Running around? Doing what?
Oh, nothing.
I mean, who can say, really?
What was that?
Basement ghost?
Don't be ridiculous. Basement ghosts don't sound anything like that.
The demon has awoken.
Domino 2, where are you? Baby Precious?
Wait, Baby Precious? That's a pet name for a pet. You sneak a pet in here?
No.
Yes.
Okay, we did.
What'd I tell you about pets?
I'm sorry. It's just that the caterpillar looked just like Anne's pet from back home. It was small, cute, it was black with white spots, and...
Wait, a black caterpillar with white spots?
Uh-oh.
Yes, sensing something is wrong.
That's a coastal caterpillar.
They're dangerous coastal caterpillar.
And they only get white spots right before they're about to...
Oh, that is the demon. And that's why the wasps were trying to kill it, because they're the natural predators, I bet.
Let's back away.
Oh, it's like a quiet place, okay. Quietly.
Hey, family! What's happening in here?
You idiot.
Run, kid!
I don't want to die in a basement!
Domino 2? It's me, Anne. We bonded. I gave you treats. You gave me dead things.
True.
Don't you remember?
Literally about to try to eat your hand. Now, that's the thing, though. It doesn't want to eat Anne. That's the thing. It eats frogs. Yeah.
Oh, she's gonna bite their heads off as soon as she's done toying with them.
Yeah, pretty much.
Wait a second.
Boy. Oh, Jesus. That is... That is a horrifying tongue. Aww.
Oh, crap.
Why does it literally sound like a cat? Literally cat sound. Alright. Not a bad OST there.
Oh, Domino 2. I thought I could change you. But I guess I was wrong. Sorry, I couldn't make it work.
Yaw, these memories from 5 minutes ago. I spent so much time with you, Domino 2. Oh my god, you've been in my life for like 7 minutes
it's
of storytelling.
Time to go.
It's so sad. I can cry.
Sayonara, Domino 2.
And man, hit him with the sayonara, Jesus.
Pop, pop, that's who?
Hey.
Anne, you're okay. Tell me that thing is gone.
Yeah, it's gone.
Or it's about to play fetch.
You guys, I had no right to put you all in danger, no matter how much I miss my cat. I hope you understand.
Understand? Understand? I miss Charlie Big Bottom with all my heart and soul.
And that's why you like to rant about Charlie Big Bottom.
Can we please fix the giant hole in the house?
Damn, you fixed that pretty fast.
Well, just
just goes to show you, you can't take some wild animal.
What the hell were you holding?
In your basement and think everything's gonna be okay.
What were you holding?
I don't know. Sometimes it works out. Oh.
You're talking about me, right?
Hey, made you a little something. I used Domino 2 scaffolds as the fur.
Ew.
Here you go. You hate it, don't you?
A little.
It's too ugly, isn't it? You know what? Give it back to me.
And it just ends like that. What the hell? That's fantastic. Oh, man, that's funny. Oh, that was really cool. Oh, man. I don't know if that was my... Oh, man. That might have actually been my favorite episode, just because it was like... I don't know. That episode was honestly kind of funny. And, like, it was just, like, stupid and, like, I don't know. Like, all the episodes have just kind of been whatever, so it's all just kind of, like, personal preference in a lot of ways. Because they're all kind of, like, they're similar episodes. They all exist to pretty much fulfill the same purpose with slight variations. But, that was a really... God, that ending was fantastic. Her face. She was way too into that. But, yeah, that was episode 4A of Amphibia. That was the domino effect, which I'm going to assume that those wasps were like a natural predator that, you know, basically deter that creature from evolving into that murderer fly. Which would make sense, and that was the domino effect, was that, you know, by saving it, you letting it into your house, you nearly killed your family. But on the flip side, it's also domino, because I feel so stupid. Wow, I can't believe I didn't put together, because we had just learned that the cat's name was Domino, and then I don't put that together. Like, that's actually, like, on me. That was a bad one. I should have made some prediction relating to the cat, but nope. Ugh. So we're about to get into the last episode of the set. We are doing episodes 2 to 4 in this set, and we have episode 4B, which is called Taking Charge. It's a bit of an aggressive title, you know, someone taking charge. That could be referring to Hot Pop, you know, Sprig, and could be a lot of different contexts, but curious to see what it's about. It's also the end of the set, so might be a strong episode, might be our best episode yet, who knows. I actually thought that 4A was potentially my favorite episode so far, so definitely on a good track in general with episode 4, so I'm curious to see what episode 4B has in store for us. So I guess we have there's no better time to jump in and check it out and see what it's all about. So without any further ado, let's jump in to episode 4B of Amphibia, season 1, Taking Charge, in 3, 2, 1, and play. Take another sip, actually. Amphibia. Taking charge already. That was a
guys. Look.
Suspicion Island, huh?
Suspicion Island. It's like my favorite show. I got the new season and didn't even know it. It must have auto-downloaded before I got here.
Oh, nice.
Auto.
Is it?
How did you download him?
Wow,
just
nice. Is it?
Watch.
Oh.
Previously. On suspicion.
Is this gonna be like Survivor?
I've got a lot of feelings about this place.
Look! More ants!
hands!
They have noses.
I feel like everyone on this island is suspicious, Peruvia. Except okay. You!
But Randy, I think you're suspicious.
Damn.
No! Suspicion Island.
If okay, no, it's a little different.
You won't stay alive.
Okay, so it's closer to Danganronpa or
this show's got beautiful people doing dumb
Squid
things.
Game
well, stuff explodes. It's literally perfect.
But it's not an actual death game, but it's closer to that.
Instead of that garbage, how about I treat you to some real entertainment?
Oh no.
A scene from The Shallow Pond. Sadness. The world.
Oh, I like the music.
Sadness. But look, there, a pond. Is it deep or no, shallow?
No, shallow. Well, that's supposed to be like Shakespeare.
Okay, fine. But just one.
It can't be Vivica. These pterodactyls are clones of my dead brother.
What?
No way.
Beautiful teens ever make it off the island?
These beautiful teens.
Next time on.
And that's enough for tonight.
Oh, come on!
This is torture!
Trust me, guys. You gotta pace yourself with this stuff.
All right, you two grubs. Off to bed.
Oh, he's addicted.
How am I supposed to sleep without he's knowing addicted. What happened to Vivica and Chad?
Do Vivica. Sleep? I don't want to watch it right now!
So, what do you think, Pop? Better than that boring stuff you read to us, right?
That boring stuff is called literature, Anne.
And yeah, he loves
if
it.
If you had an ounce of culture, you wouldn't reject it in favor of your substandard, puerile garbage show.
Oh, he loves it.
Jeez, tell me how you really feel.
Oh, he loves it. I bet $10 that he's going to run out and watch the whole thing. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, now. I was a little quick. Yeah, that's Hot Pop.
On Suspicion Island.
Island.
Come on, guys! It's time to get suspicious.
Oh, shit.
Wait, what?
It finally.
What's wrong, Ann?
What's all the ruckus?
Why are you screaming?
My battery is low, but it was fine last night when I turned it off. Huh? Watched? Who watched all these episodes and used up all the... No!
Dead!
It's gone.
What's gone?
Everything! My pictures, my texts, videos of my cat! Now all my memories from home are gone!
Damn, she's actually freaking out.
They're there.
Oh, was it you?
What? No! I didn't watch anything. It must have been Polly.
What?
I even heard her get up in the night.
Very suspicious.
It's neither of them.
Plus, if you heard me, you were awake too! You're the suspicious one!
Don't change the subject!
It's neither of them.
What about Hot Pop?
Me? In case you forgot, I despise that garbage!
Exactly! Maybe you ran down the phone so we'd have to listen to your boring play!
Well, that's good.
That is preposterous!
Enough! If none of you are going to admit to it, the least you could do is help me fix my phone!
Fair enough, Anne. How do we bring this thing back to life? Magic? Life sacrifice? I know guys.
Electrical charge.
Power! Electricity!
What?
You know, zap zap.
Zap zap? Oh, I think I know what you're talking about. Quickly, to my study!
Okay.
I've heard
Beast of Amphibia. Oh, this is...
Zapapede.
Zapapede, all right. See, I was wondering if we were going to bring up this fact of, like, her phone dying and how is she going to charge it.
Actually.
Sounds like it's worth a shot. So how far away is this bug, HP?
Don't call me HP.
HP.
It's half a day's travel. But that should be no trouble for this gang.
Oh, yeah? Well, that's just what Chad Vanderblad said. Right before he was stabbed in the back by a backstabber on Suspicion Island!
Watch where you're pointing that finger.
I would never stab Chad in the back, but one of you two would.
Hey,
wow.
Every time you
Suspicion
point...
Suspicion Island, wow, it's freaking coming both
this
ways.
This doesn't make any sense!
Hey, 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 you're all suspicious.
Oh my
just
god.
Look at you.
Literally becoming suspicious. Suspicion
come
Island.
On, let's get going.
I wonder...
The sooner we move, the sooner
so,
I get my
So the obvious twist would be that it is, in fact, Hot Pop. I wonder if it somehow ends up being none of the three. That, because that would actually be an interesting plot twist, but I imagine they're going to go with the very basic, it's Hot Pot.
A family stress each other on a dangerous mission like the nearly naked humans on the island of suspicion.
Nearly naked.
Rubia, Felicia, and Randy, so
what the hell? Damn.
Hostiling, we're all suspicious.
Tell us how you really feel, Sprig.
Look, there's one now. A sapophane.
Oh, looks pretty cute.
Step lightly, everyone. This thing doesn't look like it can take much weight.
Yeah.
Maybe you shouldn't go all at once.
Sup, HP?
Sprig sure looks tired, doesn't he? Awfully suspicious. And don't call me HP.
The old man's a lying snake, but he does have a point.
True.
You guys talking scum?
What? No.
Wow.
Psst, oh, excuse me, HP.
She keeps calling him HP.
I want to find out who's guilty just as much as you do. Let me help you.
Oh, no, you don't.
Wow. They
were trying to chat her into trusting you.
Chat her. Wow.
Into not trusting me.
Oh, and look at Hot Pop trying to Randy his way out of this.
I don't even know what that means.
Guys, cut it out.
You idiots. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Rope bridge? More like nope bridge.
Definitely a nope bridge.
Look, down there. More sapopedes.
Oh, shit. That's a lot of them.
They're pretty far down.
Hmm. Oh, well, let's just link arms and lower someone down, just like the teens did in episode 8.
Ha! So that Polly can drop us to cover her tracks, just like Vivica did in the very same episode?
You calling me a Vivica?
Maybe.
Oh, shit.
Kids,
actually
no,
fighting.
Stop fighting.
I'm brutal.
Cut it out, you guys! Seriously! Ow! Oh, sorry, Ann. You okay?
Oh, shit! Ann! Turned up the sleeves.
Stop fighting! No! Oh, no!
He's gonna admit it.
It was me!
Say what? Huh?
You mean...
That's right, Ann. I watched all the episodes! Every single one!
But you hated Suspicion Island!
Hated it? Hated it? I loved it! Ever since the end of that last episode, I couldn't sleep. I fell in love with those crazy kids on their crazy island. I couldn't get enough!
Yep.
I did the only thing I could.
I love how we're making the comp to, the living room to watch another these episode. Four with the kids from the show. What the hell?
I vowed only to watch one, but Suspicion Island had its hooks in me. And before yep. I realized what had happened, I'd finished the season. With dawn approaching, I covered my tracks and made my escape.
Nice.
Come on, guys. It's time to get suspicious.
Nice. Holy shit, bro.
Unbelievable.
What a twist.
But now, yeah. I'm gonna make things right. I will redeem myself.
Oh my god, Hot Pop.
I'm okay.
Nice, you land. I mean, the bugs
it's
are...
actually kind of relaxing.
Full charge? Half charge? Quarter charge? Anything?
We have to work together!
Hell yeah.
Almost. Nearly there. Got him! Oh, wait a second.
Yeah, that's the problem. You just gotta lift him. Oh, what the hell? Dude, I swear to God, if it says, like, 1,000% or something, like it... Oh my god, I called it! 10,000%!
That's a lot of percents.
Wow, and now her phone's never gonna die.
Island, huh?
Wow.
Yeah.
Shoutouts to the show.
I'm sorry I lied and drained your memory box.
Can memory
you
box.
Forgive this old silly frog?
Dude, you just risked your life to recharge my phone. I think we're square.
Yeah.
Aww.
Really? Now the rest of them gotta finish it. You better not spoil
me
it.
Too, Polly.
Hop, pop. If you spoil suspicion,
right,
no.
Enough metal paddling. We gotta get home so you guys can finish the season. If I don't talk to someone about it soon,
nice.
I'm gonna explode.
Nice.
I mean that part where the island itself is revealed to actually be.
No, yeah. Of course, there had to be a spoiler joke. Let's go. Classic. That was fun. That was probably the single most fun episode. So, I kind of enjoyed this set. Like, honestly, the episodes kind of just, for the most part, all got better. I don't know if that was consistent for every single episode. But I would say, like, more or less, they all just kept getting better over the course of the set. So, I had a lot of fun with that episode. That was probably my favorite episode. I actually am almost positive that was, in fact, my favorite episode of the series. We got, like, the Hop Pop being sus, you know, Hopadiah being, like, very sus. And that was literally an episode about sus, so, you know, you guys can do your stupid sus memes. Because Suspicion Island, I mean, I don't know, I don't really know. I had, like, horrible comparisons. There's, like, so many better comparisons. I said fucking DR and Squid Game, like, what the fuck? Those are terrible comparisons. I mean, they're not terrible, but they're not great. There's definitely better ones. Just the things on my mind. I guess one's recent and one is a series I'm literally doing Let's Play of on the channel and have been for, like, it feels like forever at this point. Since, oh, I guess it's been, yeah, I guess I've been Let's Playing Danganronpa at this point now for, God, has it been over a year? Or, no, it can't be. No, I guess it would have been, when did I start this? Because we should be around, like, I guess it's half a year. I guess it's been half a year because we have, what, like, 26 episodes? Because the original game was 18 episodes. Then there was the bonus episode for the school mode, and then there's been, I think I'm on 7 episodes of the second game. So yeah, I guess it's been half a year. Oh, that'll actually be the next video after this one. Will be the Christmas Eve video, will be a Danganronpa video, as well as the New Year's Eve video. So the last video of the year will be a Danganronpa video. But yeah, that was very unrelated to what's going on here, which is Amphibia. Season 1, episodes 2-4. Decent set. I think I'm gradually getting more into the show with each episode. It kind of takes me some time, especially with these type of shows. Because sometimes a show, like, really hooks me right away. And I wouldn't say I'm hooked at all with this show, as opposed to Suspicion Island, which apparently is the goat show. But I will say that I feel like by the end of this set, I was really starting to get into it. And I think part of that's because I legitimately do believe that the episodes were kind of just getting better over the course of the set in general, and I hope that trend continues in the next set, which I believe will be another 3-episode set, or another 6-segment set. Let's see. Yeah, we're going to be doing 5-7. Oh, I got the wrong sets there. We're going to be doing 5-7 next time, so it'll be another few episodes, which will be fun, but yeah, I'm into it. I'm into it. We're having fun. This was our first actual chunk because we only did like 2 parts, you know, 1 episode last time, but we got to do a lot more of Amphibia in this reaction. We got a better taste of what this series is going to be, at least in its early stages, and it was fun. It was fun. It's one of those things where if I was just, this would be the type of show that would be really nice to just. I kind of, like, at least for this part, I kind of probably wish I wasn't reacting to it, and I was just, like, on my phone, chilling on my bed, relaxing, and I just watch one episode after another and just start blasting through them. And I think that would be a more enjoyable experience for me. With most shows, I enjoy the series more because I'm reacting to it. Of course, it comes with the downside that I can't just watch the whole series all at once, which would be preferable in many cases, or at least just, like, go through a bunch before I stop. But I get to have this experience and go on this journey with you guys, but there are times where I feel like I don't add a lot to it, and hopefully you guys are still enjoying the reactions, but I think this is a series where, at least for the first few videos, Although, we'll see, we'll see. That was a really fun episode, and maybe if we get into some more interesting stuff, I'll have more to say. But it can be the case where sometimes I just don't have that much to add, and I don't have a lot to say, and I always kind of think about that. I always want to try and break down my thoughts on the episodes at least a little bit. But sometimes with certain shows, it's like very face value, very basic stuff. And it's really like, that was fun, and I made my jokes or my commentary or whatever in the episode, and then I don't really have much to say. And that's pretty much been the part, for the most part, so far with Amphibia. But hopefully you guys are still enjoying the reactions. Hopefully you guys are excited for the series. It's not that short of a series, so we have a lot of videos, so I'm sure there's going to be plenty of videos where I'm, you know, going crazy, losing my shit, or, you know, really breaking stuff down in a lot more detail than I have been so far. But, interesting. It's interesting. It's a fun show. I'm not, like, I'm far from in love with it. Animation's really nice. I like the OST. It's weird because I wouldn't compare this to Dragon Prince, because Dragon Prince is a show that I'm really into now, and the first season, I didn't really get that into it. Now, there's multiple reasons for that that aren't applicable here. I think with Dragon Prince, but if we just stick to plot, to the writing, to the narrative, I felt like with that series, it was kind of like, it felt like something was missing, or it felt like it should have been better, and even though there's a lot of things about the show that I still feel like could be better, it definitely, like, just got overall, like, a lot more interesting over time. And I feel like with this show, it doesn't necessarily feel like anything's missing. It just feels like it's just, you know, going through the process of just building things. And I like it. It's a charming show, but it's not a show that I think has me, like, it's not like, for example, when I watched, to keep it in the Disney animation television umbrella, when I watched Star vs. the Forces of Evil, I fell in love with that show so fast because the characters, and especially Star, was so charming, and it was just such a weird, like, blast of fun. And I don't get that vibe with Amphibia. While the episodes have been pretty fun, it's not like that instant connection. I haven't had a connection with this show yet. I think it's not bad. And I expect it to get really good later. I do have my hopes because you guys really love the show. But I haven't had that connection with the show yet. And I'm sure it will come in time. I really like Anne. Sprig is cool. Hop Pop is probably second favorite character. It's probably him and Anne are like tied maybe actually for first. I actually really like him, and I thought this episode was one of his best performances. Doing something that you wouldn't expect, and then the freaking, you know, nearly getting electrocuted to death and all that. Like, that was fun as hell. Like, I think him and Anne are my favorite characters so far. I'm so excited to see Marcy and Sasha. I don't think we will for quite a while, but eventually. So yeah, that's pretty much going to do it. If you guys want to support the channel, you can check out the Patreon. It's Christmas time, so if you want to give me a Christmas present, you know, that's one way to do it. All jokes aside, I appreciate the support. You guys vote on polls and stuff for movies. The next movie reaction will be coming out very shortly on Christmas. And we get one every month, and that's fun. And it's going to be 2022 very soon. I really, really unironically am hoping that I can give you guys my best year of just consistency, of intrigue, maybe of a few surprises. You know, this year was the year of the Danganronpa Let's Play, which was kind of, it was something I've talked about for a long time, but it was one of those videos, video concepts, video kind of things that I wanted to do besides just reactions. I want to do Let's Plays, especially the visual novel type content, but really just in general. I think it'd be fun. And it's something we started in 2021. So maybe in 2022, another type of video that I've been wanting to occasionally do might grace the channel, and you guys might get another type of interesting video. So hopefully you guys are looking out. We'll have to see, but maybe there'll be something a little different in 2022. Of course, the reactions will always be the focus point, but you know, there's definitely some things that I've been wanting to do for a while, and the Let's Play thing was a huge one on my list, and it's nice to be finally getting to that stuff now. And, you know, 2022, I'm hoping I could throw in another wrinkle, but of course, you know, give you guys all the normal stuff that you guys love, and add a lot more consistent. The second half of 2021 had its ebbs and flows. We're obviously just coming off of a hiatus of mine, but overall was a pretty good time. We were pretty consistent. We made a lot of progress in our shows, and that's why we're already here doing a show like Amphibia. So, yeah, it's pretty fun. I hope you guys are excited for what 2022 has in store, and I am as well. This might be the last Amphibia video of the year. There might be one more. I think there will be one more before the end of the year, but it's going to be pretty close. So if this is the last Amphibia video of 2021, I want to thank you guys for watching whatever reactions you watched in 2021 of mine. It means a lot, and I hope you guys will be around for 2022. Obviously, Amphibia reactions coming in 2022, more Amphibia reactions, as well as everything else. So thank you guys so much. Like I said, Discord and Patreon down below in the description if you want to hang out in the Discord or support me on the Patreon. And that's really it. So without any further ado, it's time for me to bid you adieu. Flamin' Shark signing out. Hope you guys have a wonderful, fantastical day. And I'll see you next time with another video. Thanks for watching. Peace.